our Lord Jesus Christ,
the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with this spirit.
As we begin our Eucharist, we once again open our hearts to the unconditional and merciful love and forgiveness of our God. Lord, we have sinned against you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, you plead for us at the right hand of your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Be near, O Lord, to those who plead before you, and look kindly on those who place their hope in your mercy, that cleansed from the stain of their sins, they may persevere in holy living and be made full heirs of your promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. When Abraham prostrated himself, God spoke to him, "My covenant is with you. My covenant with you is this. You are to become the father of a host of nations. No longer shall you be called Abraham, but your name shall be Abraham. For I am making you the father of a host of nations. I will render you exceedingly fertile. I will make nations of you. Kings shall stem from you. I will maintain my covenant with you and your descendants after you, throughout the ages as an everlasting pact, to be your God and the God of your descendants after you. I will give to you and to your descendants after you the land in which you are now staying, the whole land of Canaan, as a permanent possession, and I will be their God." God also said to Abraham, "On your part, you and your descendants after you must keep my covenant throughout the ages." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered. Remember, the Lord remembers his covenant. You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembered forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever keeps my word will never see death." So the Jews said to him, "Now we are sure that you are possessed. Abraham died, as did the prophets, yet you say, whoever keeps my word will never taste death. Are you greater than our father Abraham, who died? Are the prophets who died? Who do you make yourself out to be?" Jesus answered, "If I glorify myself, my glory is worth nothing. But it is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say, he is our God. Yet you do not know him, but I know him. And if I should say that I do not know him, I would be like you, a liar. But I do know him, and I keep his word. Abraham, your father, rejoiced to see my day. He saw and was glad." So the Jews said to him, "You are not yet 50 years old, and you have seen Abraham?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, before Abraham came to be, I am." So they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid and went out of the temple area. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I was a kid, you could send in the top of an Ovaltine jar and get a Captain Marvel decoder ring. And with this decoder ring, you could find out secret messages and secret codes from the secret codes. The Gospel of John today has a code for us. And throughout John's Gospel, this code runs through there. And Jesus tells us today, as he tells the Jews, the words, "I am." And that's the code, as it were, in John's Gospel, that tells us that Jesus is indeed divine. He is God. He is the Son of God. And so throughout the Gospel, we hear Jesus say different versions of "I am." "I am the light of the world. I am the vine, and you are the branches. I am the bread of life. I am the resurrection and the life." Throughout his gospel, John is emphasizing to us that Jesus is indeed the Son of God, that he is the fulfillment of the covenant, that he is the one who brings to life, as it were, God's promises come to its fulfillment. Those promises that we heard in the covenant is our first reading today from the book of Genesis. Abraham to be a father of many peoples, father of a great nation, even though Abraham had no children, that in the midst of seemingly impossibility, God would be true to his faithfulness. So too for us, and in the time of Jesus, in the midst of this Lenten time, when we think of Jesus' approaching death, we're reminded of God's promise. His promise to be with us, his promise of love, his promise that he will always be here. Jesus is indeed, "I am," the God who lives among us. As God is faithful to the covenant, we pray for those graces for ourselves, that we too can be faithful to our end of the bargain or the agreement, that we may be indeed members of that covenant. We pray that those two great commandments that Jesus gave to us, to love God above all things and to love our neighbor as ourselves, that we may more and more have those as a part of our life. That as God is true and faithful to the covenant, so too may we be faithful and true to the covenant. In this time when our world seems pretty dark, and there's challenges and difficulties all around us, the Word of God today is a promise of hope, that even in the midst of this darkness, God is with us. God loves us. pray that we too may be faithful to that covenant. And so as we consider ourselves and shelter in our homes these days, we are reminded and called not to forget people who don't have homes. People have no place to shelter because they're homeless and they live on our streets. We pray that our hearts may be open to them in ways that we can reach out in love and care. We pray that as we experience empty grocery shelves and difficulties of getting the foods that we would like, we remember the many people in our world who don't have food or pure water. And we again ask the Lord to give us the grace and the generosity that we too can reach out to them, that our hearts may be open to them in ways that we can help them. On these days when we are called to not move around, to stay in our places, we are reminded of the people who never get to move around because they're in refugee camps and other forms of camps because no nation will allow them in. We pray that they too may be able to find a home and that our own hearts may be open. On these days when it seems as if nature has turned against us with this virus, we remember indeed our call to be good stewards of creation, that we see all of creation as a blessing and a gift from God to share with all of his people. We renew ourselves today in the covenant. Most of all, we remember the great promise of God to be with us always and his faithfulness to the covenant. And we pray for the graces today as we continue in this Lenten time that we can be faithful to the covenant, to love God above all, and to love our neighbor as ourselves. Pray for the graces as we continue in this Lenten season to be a people of repentance and conversion. We pray to the Lord. That we may all be good stewards of creation and the gifts that God has given to us. We pray to the Lord. For those that are homeless, those that are seeking a place to live, a place to call, we pray to the Lord. For all who are caring for us, for the care that we give to one another, that God's protection may be with all of us, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, members of our parish and members of our families, we pray to the Lord. For all families, that they may grow in the love of one another, for those that are hurting, that God may help to heal the hurts that are there, we pray to the Lord. For the intentions that have been listed on our altar, for those whom we have promised to pray for, and those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord. Loving and caring God, continue to shower your blessings and your love upon us, and hear our prayers that we offer in Jesus' name.
are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer you. Through the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
And in our rest and sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our glory and the love of all his holy church.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these sacrificial offerings, that they may profit our conversion and the salvation of all the world. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all of the angels and the saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we together acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work, so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death, and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched heaven and earth, to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up."
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and the resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim, who reconciles to you the grace. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division.
Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and God,
mercy, Lord, that by the same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good celebrating the Eucharist with all of you today. Bow your heads down and pray for God's blessing. Be gracious to your people, Lord, we pray, that as from day to day they reject what does not please you, they may be filled instead with the light at your commands. Bless them today and